自《爱经》。一个洁净的善行者，为了解脱，获得宁静，他应该如是修学，能干，诚恳，端正，直接，恭敬，易交，温和，不高傲，知足，易养，少管事，生活简朴，诸根极净，技能完善，谨慎，谦虚，不粗鲁，不攀求，不执着于俗家，不做任何事后将受智者指责之事。这样的想，愿一切众生喜乐平安，愿一切众生心得喜乐。所有的众生，无论是弱或强，长或大，中等或短小，精细或粗显的，可见或不可见，远或近，已出生的或将投生的，愿一切众生都快乐。愿人们不相互欺骗，或在任何地方轻视任何人，不应以愤怒、敌意而诅咒希望他人受苦。正如一位母亲舍命保护自己唯一的儿子，他更应当对一切众生，让他散发出无量的慈心，以对整个宇宙散发出无量的慈爱，自上自下，遍及四方，无障碍，无嗔恨，无敌意。无论是站着、走着、坐着、卧着，凡清醒时，他应当确立此念，觉醒正念，能如是住者，这便称为即时即地的梵住之心，不落入邪见，有戒德，具足之见即断除感官贪欲，他将肯定不再投胎。愿以我对正法的坚定信心而离苦得乐，健康平静。萨度萨度萨度。
Discourse on loving kindness that should be done. He who is skilled in doing good,and who wishes to attain that state of calm, Nibbana, should act thus. He must work to be efficient, right, perfectly upright, obedient, gentle, and humble, contented, easily supportable, not a burden to others, with few duties, simple in livelihood, controlled in senses, discreet,not impudent, not greedily attached to families. He should not commit any slight wrong so that other wise men might deplore. May all beings be happy and secure. May their hearts be wholesome. Whatsoever living beings that exist, weak or strong, without exception, long, stout or medium, short,small or large, those seen visible or unseen not visible, and those dwelling far or near, those who are born, and those who are to be born. May all beings, without exception, be happy-minded. Let no one deceive another, nor despise anyone anywhere. In anger or ill will, let them not wish any harm to another. Just as a mother would guard her only child at the risk of her own life, even so towards all beings, let him cultivate boundless loving kindness. Towards the entire world, let him radiate boundless loving kindness. Above, below, and across, without any obstruction, without any hatred, without any enmity. Whether he stands, walks, sits, or lies down, as long as he is awake, he should develop this mindfulness. This, they say, is the highest conduct here. Not falling into wrong views, being virtuous and endowed with perfect insight, totally eradicated desire for sensual objects. Truly, he will never come to be reborn in the womb again. By the firm determination of this truth, may I ever be well. By the firm determination of this truth, may I be free from illness. By the firm determination of this truth, may peaceful victory be mine. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
实践慈爱经的十一项功德。慈心功德经，南传大藏经，增支部十一支法增义。如是我闻，一时佛在舍卫国，给孤独长者的奇树园精舍。世尊召集比丘们，然后对他们说，比丘们，熟悉慈心观的行者，将能证得心解脱。经常修习培育慈心的行者，常养慈心渐次掌握它，以慈心为方便，并常珍惜它。心住于慈，身心于慈，该行者经过培育慈心后，将能获得十一种利益。这些利益是：一、睡得安稳；二、醒时精神舒畅；三、不做噩梦；四、人所敬爱；五、非人也敬爱；六、天神护卫；七、刀兵火毒不能侵害；八、心意入定；九、仪态安详；十、死时心不颠倒；十一、今生若未证得罗汉果，也将能升到梵天界。比丘们，熟悉慈心观的行者，将能证得心解脱。经常学习培育慈心观的行者，常养慈心渐次掌握它，以慈心为方便，并常珍惜它。心住于慈，身心于慈，该行者经过培育慈心后，将能获得这十一种利益。佛陀说完已，众比丘皆欢喜信受。萨埵萨埵萨埵。
The 11 benefits of practicing the Karaniya Metta Sutta. 1. Sleep comfortably. 2. Wake from sleep comfortably. 3. Without nightmares. 4. Respected and loved by human beings. 5. respected and loved by non-human beings. 6. Protected and guarded by deities. 7. Not harmed by weapon, fire, or poison. 8. Achieve concentration with ease during meditation. 9. Calm and serene facial complexion. 10. Peaceful and calm at death without negative thoughts. 11. If one does not attain arahantship in this lifetime, one will be reborn in the Brahma world after death. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.